it wouldn't do much good to track all the batch information in your system without having tools that allow you would allow you to see the batch information and actually do some comparative analysis between runs. And so in this section, we're going to talk about the client tools. We have a lot of different client tools. Our main client tools, generic client tools, are considered ProcessBook, PI DataLink, and RT Web Parts. And we have specific batch-related tools. There's PI BatchView, which we'll be talking about in this class. There's also a product that is marketed by a partner of ours called PI Process Templates. And then there's something we have called RT Reports that allow you to do batch reporting. That's in another course. Of course, any custom application that you have written or any application using ODBC or EarlyDB can get batch data out of the PI system. One of the main ways people use BatchView is in its form as an add-in to ProcessBook. And ProcessBook is talked about and discussed in many of our classes. I'd like to just take a few moments and explain some of the features of ProcessBook for people that are not familiar with the tool. I've opened up ProcessBook, but I don't have a file open yet, so I'm going to select File and New, and I'm going to create a new display file. A display file is what people use to view data. Now, once I get my display file open, I can maximize it. And there are two types of elements that you can put on this screen. I'm going to click on a little hammer to go into build mode, and then the draw menu exposes all of the elements that we have available in this ProcessBook display. And you can see that there are a combination of static and dynamic elements. There are the common static elements like rectangle. All I did was click on rectangle and then drew a rectangle on the screen. I can you notice that it went back into run mode. This is the arrow. I can go into build mode, single click on this element, and resize it or move it or do anything I wish with it. But ProcessBook isn't just known for the little static graphics that it can display. ProcessBook is known for its dynamic elements, and one of the most common dynamic elements is the trend. So I'll select draw and trend. I'll then draw a box on the screen, and I get my defined trend dialog box. And the defined trend dialog box is going to ask you three things. It's going to ask you what the data or tags are, the scale, which is the vertical or y-axis, and the time, which is your x-axis. And you can see the default is to look back over 8 hours. Well, if I do a tag search and I go and get a tag, I have some batch simulation tags that start with the letters BA colon. So I'm going to type in BA colon and an asterisk, which means wildcard. And I'm going to look at this BA temp tag. This is a tag that measures the temperature in my batch reactor. And I can see that over the last 8 hours, I've had a series of batch runs. I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and it looks like because I'm at 0 on between runs, I've got 6 batch runs, and I can see that I have a process that looks fairly repeatable, but in the standard ProcessBook trend, it's a little bit difficult to see any variations between these. I can sort of see that there are variations visually, but it's hard because they're sequenced over time. A little bit later, we're going to show you how to draw a special trend using our BatchView product that allows you to overlay these trends, and you can clearly and easily see how they look when superimposed over one another. PI DataLink is one of our client tools. It's one of our most popular tools, and it's an add-in to Microsoft Excel. We also have a Lotus 1-2-3 add-in, and it exposes itself in a menu in Excel. And if I open up Excel and I click under add-ins, you can see that we have PI and PI SMT. The PI SMT is our system manager tools. We're going to ignore those for this discussion. But if I click on the PI menu, I can see all of the PI data link functions. And if I have batch view installed, I'll see batch search at the top. So what do people use data link for? Well, primarily to retrieve data from the PI system. If I wanted to retrieve the last hour's worth of data for a given tag, I would select the compressed data start time end time function. And you'll notice it's going to ask me for tag name, PI server, start time, and end time. So let's put a tag name of sinusoid in. For the start time, we'll go back minus 1 hour. The asterisk minus 1 hour means now minus 1 hour. And the end time is now. This will give me the last 60 minutes worth of values from the PI server. And I want to make sure that I show my timestamps. I'll click OK. And you can see that over the last hour for this given tag, I have two values. So you can see where the PI DataLink function would be very valuable to someone who wants to see data in the PI system, whether it be over the last hour or over the last 8 hours. We're going to see in this section of the class how to specifically use the batch search function to look at batch type data in a Microsoft Excel spreadsheet format. PI BatchView takes data that would normally be presented over time, and it breaks it out by its start times and end times. As you can see in this diagram, we've got some data, and it clearly represents some data that is in repeatable time segments. We've got four runs or batches here that can clearly be analyzed against one another as opposed to just against time. And that's what PI BatchView does. PI BatchView looks at process data framed in terms of a start time and end time. And this is a shot of the PI BatchView batch group in ProcessBook, where we have a search function, a results, a Gantt chart, and finally trend objects. And this is showing data that's much the same as we saw in the previous screen, but this data is organized, so you're comparing one run to another, as opposed to just data over time. Now the PI BatchView add-in or product comes actually in three distinct visible components. There is a quick search tool. If you just want to see some batch data without having to open up one of your client tools, you can run the quick search. We have a PI ProcessBook add-in, which we saw in the earlier screenshot, that allows us to see our batch data. And then we have an add-in for Excel, and it is integrated with our PI DataLink product. So you can have all those three components to see your batch data. There's also distributed ActiveX controls that you can program against as well.